In the previous lesson, we learned about the different types of connections that can be defined in Ansys Mechanical. In this lesson, we will delve deeper into contact connections, understand how they are implemented, and discuss the assumptions we make when using different types of contact connections. So firstly, why do we need to model contact explicitly? We all know that when two bodies come in physical contact, they exert forces on each other. This is how they detect each other's presence. For example, in case of a bolted joint, when the bolt head and one of the mating components come in contact with each other, they exert contact forces on the other body. Depending on the relative stiffness of the bolt head and the mating component, both the bodies may deform to some extent. If the parts are touching initially or start to touch due to deformation, then the force is transferred over a finite area, which is the contact pressure. Now we may be interested in seeing whether the contact pressure over the mating components is sufficient to achieve proper sealing. Capturing how this contact pressure is distributed over the area of contact is the main objective of contact formulation. Failure to model contact may result in various parts penetrating each other. Hence, in case of bolted joints, contact between the bolt head, the nut, and the mating components is essential for defining bolt preload and for capturing the interaction between them. So now that we have established that modeling contact is absolutely essential in case of bolted joints, let's look at how contact is modeled numerically. Contact is modeled by enforcing three rules, which are physically very intuitive. First, two bodies in contact should not penetrate each other. Second, the applied forces and the contact forces have to balance each other out in the case of static problems. And third, if we have a dynamic problem at hand, then conservation of momentum must be enforced. While there are several contact formulations to enforce these conditions, we will focus our attention on augmented Lagrange formulation, which uses a form of what is called penalty method. In Ansys Mechanical, augmented Lagrange formulation is used as the default contact formulation due to its robustness in terms of both accuracy and efficiency. So now we will discuss the penalty method a little bit to understand how it is implemented. The penalty method treats contact as a stiff spring that resists bodies from penetrating each other. So imagine we have two bodies that are close to each other but not touching each other yet. If the bodies are not touching each other, there are no contact interactions and the spring does not come into play yet. But once the two bodies touch each other, imagine the two contacting surfaces being connected by a spring. Now, if this spring is very stiff, the two surfaces cannot penetrate each other much. But if this spring is flexible, then the two surfaces can penetrate each other significantly, which of course will give inaccurate results. The stiffness of the spring, which provides resistance to interpenetration of two bodies, is known as the contact stiffness. As discussed before, the contact stiffness should be large enough to reduce the penetration to close to zero. The contact stiffness depends on several factors, such as the material properties of both the bodies, the geometry of the bodies, their kinematics, etc. For example, if the two bodies coming in contact are very soft, then the contact stiffness will be smaller as compared to contact stiffness between two very stiff, almost rigid bodies. Similarly, if the two mating parts are shells made of steel, they will be more deformable as compared to two thick blocks made of steel. So in this case, although the contacting parts are made of steel in both the cases, the contact stiffness will be smaller in the first case. Contact stiffness is used both in the normal and tangential directions. Contact stiffness in the normal direction provides resistance to penetration between the two surfaces, while contact stiffness in tangential direction provides resistance to relative sliding between the two surfaces. Now, ideally, there should be absolutely no penetration between the two contacting bodies. But for this to happen, the stiffness of the contact spring would need to be close to infinity. Since it is not possible to implement this practically, the penalty formulation allows for a small amount of penetration, delta U, between the two bodies. This delta U is the amount by which the contact spring gets deformed and thus develops a restoring force Fc, given by the product of the contact stiffness Kc and the penetration delta U. This restoring force is the contact force which leads to deformation of the contacting surfaces. Thus, the contact stiffness should be large enough to provide a sufficient contact force, which in turn will reduce the penetration to close to zero. But if the contact stiffness is too high, that is, if we make the two contacting surfaces very stiff, we may observe some contact chatter. So an appropriate value of contact stiffness should be chosen such that both these criteria are fulfilled. Ansys Mechanical automatically calculates a default contact stiffness value and may adjust this during solution to provide more accurate solutions. When defining contact between two bodies or surfaces in Ansys Mechanical, we need to define the contact side and the target side. We have seen this in the workshops for the previous two sections. The main factor distinguishing the contact and the target sides is that contact elements cannot penetrate the target surface, but target elements can penetrate through the contact side. Also, contact variables such as contact status, contact pressure, etc. are calculated only on the contact side and not the target side. The rule of thumb is to define the body with the stiffer material as the target side and the body with the softer material as the contact side. For example, copper is softer than steel. So if steel bolts are used to connect copper flanges, the bolt head will be the target side and the copper flange will be the contact side. We saw another example in the Section 1 workshop where steel bolts were used to connect two rigid parts together. Since rigid bodies have the highest stiffness, we modeled the rigid components as the target side and the steel bolts as the contact side. If both the surfaces in the contact pair are made of the same material, for example, steel bolts connecting steel flanges, then the geometry of the connecting surfaces is considered. Example, consider a steel bolt clamping together two thin steel plates. Although both the bolt and the plates are made of steel, due to different geometries, the steel bolt head will most likely be stiffer than the thin steel plate it is touching. So, the bolt head will be the target side and the plate will be the contact side. Another rule that is generally followed is that the surface with finer mesh is chosen to be the contact side, while the one with the coarser mesh is chosen to be the target side.